L'Esprit de Dieu repose sur moi. L'Esprit de Dieu m'a consacré. L'Esprit de Dieu m'a envoyé proclamer la paix, la joie.
Brothers and sisters in the Spirit and family, if we are honest with ourselves, we have a long way to go to bridge the gap between the way we live and what we actually profess to be in our spirit and rule of life and in our chapter documents. The words of Paul VI, written so many years ago, remain still very relevant for us today. We are being asked with insistence, do you really believe what you are proclaiming? Do you live what you believe? Do you really preach what you live? Together we will reread the first chapter of our Spirit and Rule of Life. We'll ask ourselves, what does it really mean to be a Spiritan today, in today's world, in the footsteps of Claude Goulart-Delplas and Francis Liberman? How can we be more true to our stated purpose in our Rule of Life to evangelize the poor? How can we live more effectively our apostolic spirit in the spirit of practical union?
Ils étaient plus collaborateurs avec nous, si je peux dire, pour notre formation complète, le petit garçon qui grandissait.
I myself was a student in one of the Spiritan high schools in Trinidad. The influence of the Spiritans was very strong, and one in particular, an Irish Spiritan father called James Brett, was a very strong influence. He was a man who involved himself in the life of the country, in the lives of his students, the lives of their parents, and so he really influenced many of us.
Alors ce qui m'a conduit chez les spiritains, c'est d'abord cette attention vers les plus démunis. Je me rappelle étant tout jeune, tout petit, dans ma paroisse natale, c'était les Spiritains qui géraient cette paroisse, cette mission. Ce qui me frappait à l'époque, quand on savait que le blanc, c'est quelqu'un de riche, c'est l'image qui a été véhiculée, c'est quelqu'un d'aisé, c'est quelqu'un de bien placé, et qu'on voyait que ces gens-là qui étaient chez nous, dans un village pauvre, abandonné, dans la forêt, allaient rencontrer les familles. Moi, ça m'avait frappé de voir ce missionnaire, ce blanc au fond de la forêt, avec des noirs. C'est une image qui m'est restée. Je me suis dit, mais tiens, comment aussi je peux imiter cet homme-là, qui se fait vraiment tout petit. Je n'avais pas encore ce vocabulaire-là, se faire tout petit, se faire un avec les autres.
There was Mission Sunday. There was Mission Sunday, and our programs that were organized to promote vocations. And then I was given this small booklet called Wito. Wito means vocation. So I read, I saw HGF, Holy Ghost Fathers. Eh?
Yes.
And then I remembered the priest was working at home, who was taking us into the outstations. His beetle, the small car beetle, was written HGF. Then I said, this must be the people who are working there at home.
Foi vendo a maneira como eles trabalhavam com as pessoas, o trato com as pessoas, com os líderes das comunidades, e fui conhecendo pouco a pouco o carisma, a maneira de ser, a maneira de acolher dos espiritanos. Eles sempre partilhavam os trabalhos, as atividades, cuidavam muito da formação dos leigos.
I will hold your people in my heart.
A história vocacional nasceu em los campos de Extremadura, donde las personas no podían venir al pueblo, estaban alejados y no podían tener escuela, los niños crecían pues y no podían recibir la educación que los otros niños tenían porque estaban lejos del pueblo, y ese fue el nacimiento de mi vocación. Yo era ya seminarista diocesano, pero había en mí una inquietud de que realmente no me gustaba ser el sacerdote del pueblo, sino dedicar mi vida a los pobres. Y fue ahí donde nació mi vocación por la misión.
A minha história se resume pelo fato de que a minha família, a minha mãe, por exemplo, todo dia ia na missa e me levava juntos com ela. E assim foi criando uma intimidade na vida de oração. E o padre, o espiritano, né, foi observando isso. E um dia ele me chamou, mesmo sem ter seminário. E passou o tempo. E um dia eu resolvi dizer sim, e assim começou. O Seminário Espiritano em Cruzeiro do Sul, por exemplo, iniciou comigo, na verdade.
My initial contact with the Spiritans began very early in my life. The Irish Holy Ghost Fathers and missionaries evangelized my part of the country, the then Eastern Nigeria, popularly known as the Igbo Land. They baptized my parents and me too.
I knew the Spiritans in high school, and I was very impressed by their relations with each other and with the students, the way they carried themselves. And then when I entered formation, I had that experience myself in terms of sharing ideas, sharing a common life, sharing a common vision for what it meant to be a Spirit.
Je connaissais les Spiritains. Lorsque j'ai rencontré les communautés spirituelles, j'ai trouvé que leur style de vie était simple, il y avait des relations faciles avec les spiritains. Alors, ça m'a plus capté la vie des spiritains. Que... C'est une bonne question.
Pour ceux qui ont besoin de faire venir,
identity is a very big word, and it sounds very heavy.
Le socle de l'identité spirituelle, c'est l'habitude de la vie intérieure dans l'Esprit Saint. Une vie d'apostolat, mais qui est conduite du dedans par l'Esprit Saint qui nous anime.
É especial devoção ao Espírito Santo, a docilidade a Ele. Deixar-se conduzir por ele, tanto na vida pessoal quanto na missão.
Spiritan, spirituality, is essentially a desire for practical union with God, expressed through prayer, personal or communal, in a fraternal life in the spirit of our founders. Our spiritualness is particularly manifested in our mission and charism, the preferential option for the poor and the marginalized.
The dedication for the poor.
A opção preferencial pelos pobres é a mesma opção de Jesus.
Is the idea of walking among the poor. When I was growing up, I saw many spirit dancers walking difficult areas in Nigeria among the poor. I remember following one of them to service one day, and there, you know, the way he related with the poor people, for them to eat, as he said, he was able to eat the food they presented, you know, before him. And the poor people were very comfortable with him. They felt happy in his presence. You know, I got attracted to, you know, to this kind of mission work, to work among the poor. As then, I wished to work among the poor. And I thank God I realized my aim of working among the poor people. I worked in South Africa, in Freire, among the poor people, and enjoyed it.
La misión con los pobres, y sobre todo con los pobres, más pobres. Esa fue mi acción. Después, la manera de cómo realizarla. En la sencillez, en la disponibilidad y, sobre todo, en la espiritualidad de los fundadores.
Una especie de contacto, de apertura, que sea en la vida espiritual, en la vida de todos los días, una apertura a lo que es otro, y luego en la simplicidad.
I would say it's a simplicity in the way that Spiritans relate to people. There's an openness and there's not any attempt to try to impress someone.
We do this as servants in all humility and openness.
Cette simplicité tout en étant sérieux. Je l'ai vu chez le spiritain, quelqu'un qui fait des grandes choses, mais sans trop faire de bruit. Quelqu'un de sérieux sans trop le dire. Quelqu'un qui réussit à atteindre ses objectifs avec peu de moyens.
I remember reading the life of Liberman as a novice. When I read about his human challenges, I said, this is a very ordinary man facing very human challenges, and I found that very attractive.
For me, it's a passion for the work of evangelization, the work of sharing the good news. It's the ability to kind of relate to people on a very down-to-earth basis and share that, the good news that we have, and that spirit of commitment to the poor.
The missionary aspect, to be ready to be sent, to be sent. Break even outside your own culture. And for me, I think that is very, very enriching. Okay. And then another thing is community living. Community living, and I see these things as very, very important for me.
Também a vida comunitária é um aspecto para mim muito, muito importante da identidade espiritana, porque através dela se testemunha em conjunto dentro da missão com as pessoas. Na realidade onde estamos. Claro que também se corre o risco aí de, muitas vezes, se os membros não estão bem centrados no que é o carisma, a espiritualidade, a herança dos fundadores, toda a riqueza que ela encerra, podem também se perder, não?
Dans ta vie spirituelle, qu'est-ce qui te donne de l'énergie? Qu'est-ce qui te fait sentir entier, réalisé?
Eh bien, c'est une belle question, mais je vais répondre à ce qui est véritablement ma vie, et ma vie personnelle depuis toujours. c'est vraiment leur raison quotidienne. Voilà, parce que dans la question que tu poses, tu parles d'énergie, tu parles d'être tout entier réalisé. Moi, tout ça, je le recueille dans leur raison quotidienne.
First and foremost, the generosity and love of God. God has been too good to me in many ways. I have experienced His love, gifts, and blessings to the degree that I can do many things in Him who strengthens me.
For me, it's always learning from the people that I'm working with as well. So it's not me teaching, or it's being one with the people and being enriched by the experience of the people. And I found that all of my ministries, the people I've been assigned to work with, have all enriched me much more than I've been able to do this.
Dans la rencontre des gens avec la parole de Dieu, il me semble que ça se déroule, puis j'apprends de plus en plus. Puis c'est comme si mon identité spirituelle se forge à même ma rencontre avec les autres, puis avec les choses que je découvre au fur et à mesure.
Brenda, founders Pula de Place and Francis Mary Paul Lieberman, to God in the service of mission. Their example, like the love of Christ, urges and sustains me in my mission and apostolate as a spiritual.
Creo que es muy importante el mensaje que nos dejó Pula de Place y Lieberman. Es un mensaje con un contenido profundo evangélico, de oración, de realizarnos como hombres realmente evangélicos, dedicados completamente a nosotros, a los pobres. Y eso creo que es lo que más me entusiasma y lo que más me lleva a seguir trabajando y comunicar a los demás que realmente el carisma espiritano está hoy todavía vivo y que muchos pueden beber en él.
And equally very important source of energy in my life as a Spiritan is the support of my confreres. This is one of the wonderful advantages of community life, our life in common. I have found a home and belonging in most of the Spiritan communities I experienced, both at home and at work. Has a great potential of flavoring our missionary apostle and witnessing than anyone can imagine. The power and the beauty of unity and diversity.
O que me deixa realmente entusiasmado e cheio de esperança é que nós não cumprimos nossa missão totalmente. Primeiro que a missão é de Deus. Ela é ampla, é sem fim. E depois eu sinto que nós ainda temos muito a oferecer nos dias de hoje, para o mundo de hoje, para a sociedade de hoje.
I think that the area of witness and to continue the story of the spirit and missionaries, for so many years, more than 310 years, and we are part of that. And for me, I'm very passionate that I'm part of that history, and then it will continue. When I see what the Spiritans have done in the area of evangelization, I try to ask myself today, what could we do also to continue that story?
Creo que el carisma espiritano tiene que decir mucho a la Iglesia de hoy.
Alleluia.
We are all invited to a collective rediscovery Spiritan congregation to make a pilgrimage into our past so that the intuitions, the vision, and the dreams of our founders can reshape our spirituality, our lifestyle, and our mission today. May the Holy Spirit accompany us on our pilgrimage.
看见听见主耶稣，天主的爱与我们同行，因信有故，使我们成为黑暗中照耀的光，为他作证。哈利路亚，为他作证。哈利路亚。